U.S. President Biden drops his re-election bid and endorses Vice President Kamala Harris to replace him. Biden's choice is reportedly gaining support among Democrats. The details from our North America correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
A seismic shift in the race for the White House. 81-year-old Democratic President Joe Biden has ended his re-election bid and has endorsed 59-year-old Vice President Kamala Harris to take on the Republican Party's presidential nominee, 78-year-old Donald Trump. Biden's stunning decision to drop out of the 2024 presidential race on Sunday came after intense pressure from Democratic leaders, including Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer and more than 30 House lawmakers. After Biden's poor debate performance against Trump last month and due to concerns over his age and mental acuity. Before Biden, no incumbent eligible for another term has dropped out of the election in nearly half a century. In a letter posted on social media, Biden said it has been his greatest honor to serve as president. And while it has been his intention to seek re-election, he believes it is in the best interest of the Democratic Party and the country for him to stand down and focus solely on fulfilling his duties as president for the remainder of his term. Biden made this announcement from his home in Delaware, where he's been recovering from COVID-19. Immediately thereafter, he expressed his full support and endorsement for Harris to be the Democratic Party's nominee. He told Democrats, "It's time to come together to beat Trump." Harris reportedly spoke with Biden several times on Sunday morning ahead of his announcement, said she's honored to have Biden's endorsement and she intends to earn and win this nomination. Harris could become the first Black woman and the first Asian woman to become the Democratic Party's presidential nominee. This shakeup in the Democratic Party comes just weeks before the party's national convention in Chicago beginning August 19. The party plans to have a virtual roll call to formally nominate its presidential candidate, reportedly on August 1. The Democrats could have the presidential nominee before the convention kicks off. Grassroots support for Harris is fired up. Small dollar donors have raised close to $47 million following Harris's presidential campaign launch, the biggest fundraising day of the 2024 cycle. Harris was already endorsed by the powerful Congressional Black Caucus, several key donors and lawmakers, and super PACs.
Kamala has been a ferocious warrior on the issue of abortion, and under Kamala's leadership, we're going to get Roe versus Wade back into law of the land. But the part that's fun to think about is when you're up against a convicted felon, who better than a former prosecutor to take it straight to Donald Trump?
The only Filipino in the U.S. Congress, Virginia's Bobby Scott, took to social media to say that the only person best situated to defeat Trump is Harris, adding Harris is ready to serve and will make a great president. Meanwhile, other possible contenders for the Democratic presidential nomination, including California Governor Gavin Newsom and Pennsylvania Governor Josh Shapiro, quickly endorsed Harris. Former President Barack Obama and ex-House Speaker Nancy Pelosi praised Biden for deciding to step aside from the presidential race, but have not endorsed Harris just yet. Henny Espinosa, ABS-CBN News.